solo stuff, some of his contemporary Christian stuff, and some of his stuff from Grand Funk Railroad. Ladies and gentlemen, the engine that drove the train, Mark Farner of Grand Funk Railroad!
Yeah! little less of that other keyboard on the other side of the music, please. Came off an album. You remember the album that had those three faces stacked up in the eyeballs? Because we ain't doing nothing from that. Just check and see if you remember. Nah, I'm lying. Just practicing my lying. Someday I'll be a good politician, but I'll tell you.
we go.
Your arm getting tired.
Time for a commercial break here. This stuff is guaranteed not to rip, rattle, will tear, bust out that the seams under pressure. It'll whiten your gums, it'll brighten your teeth, and if you buy now, you'll get a free set again soon enough. You won't have to sing the blues no more.
Hey,
record 1977 on Atlantic. This is like maybe some of you people is born back in the 60s, 50s, 40s. You remember the album that had that clock that was running backwards and down low was holding the thing out there like that? I had the three cigars. I was 20 years old!
One thing about it, she won't
gripe
about me driving tonight.
Well, had something to say.
Yeah.
Don't want you.
do the first song that I ever wrote. I wrote this thing, because, you know, I started playing guitar when I was 15 years old.
Yeah.
we woke somebody up, you
You're looking at it, you're listening about it. I can see it, but I wasn't paying attention to it.
Long before we had any top 40 hits, Grand Funk was played on FM Underground. You remember FM Underground when it was all music and no commercial? Now tell me where we can hear the music. Everything's an infomercial. Well, this is one of these songs that was back from that era, and I guarantee you ain't gonna hear no commercial in between this one.
Yes, sir! Woo!
Oh, yes. A little sweat on the strings. Real good for the intonation. Thank you. How many of y'all are very versed in every aspect of the Constitution? Very versed in every aspect. How many of you really versed at the bottom line on that savings account booklet? Somebody, now come on. You know what that balance is. Now, if you didn't, how would you know when you're getting ripped off? There are some things we keep real good track of, but I think we got our values in this place, brothers and sisters. I think that that Constitution establishes me and you as we, the people. That piece of paper, which has been preserved with the blood of men and women who've laid down their life, that we can sit here in freedom tonight. That Constitution is way more valuable than anything you could put in the bank. Do you know the balance in your account? Do you know when somebody's trying to rip you off? We got some learning to do, and we got some teaching to do. And I got four sons, range from 20 years old out to 10 years old. And I just want to take this moment, because it's so silent, and I think y'all can hear me. I was mad when I had to tell my little Jesse about oral sex. But it was in the front papers, in the front page of the papers. It was all over the news. And when he comes to daddy, what's oral sex? And I thought, how many parents have kids younger than mine coming to them and say, Mommy, Daddy, well, you know, must be okay. Shoot, he says, all right. And he's still there. Hey, it ain't adultery according to his Bible. Something in the milk ain't cream. It is not a bill of privileges, and I got an issue that I think is the number one concern of a bill of rights, because if they get this right away from us, reach over, flush that porcelain thing down, because they're all going down. We need to have coercive force in the hands of peaceful people in this world. You know that. You want to see a good example of gun control? Look at China. Look at Mexico. More murder rates. I mean, twice the murder rate per capita. We ain't talking about apples. We're talking apples and apples. Twice the murder rate as the United States, and they took the guns away from them people in 1968. They used machetes and scissors, what do you mean, baseball bat?
Go on now.
We got something to say. Frank Zappa produced this album back in 1976, and he says, guys, let's just call it what it is. Good singing, good playing. Maybe you remember this song from that album.
That my daddy told me the basic fundamentals if you want to be free. But son, there's something wrong internally. So if you want your freedom, son, don't want your country to be overrun. We've got to keep America. Thank you.
Yeah, I'm tired of the mainstream news media fluff. Extra creamy. Cool Whip. Don't get me wrong, I like Cool Whip. On strawberry rhubarb pie. Woo-hoo-hoo! Starting to get hungry. What I want is one of them golf carts. I think this is way cool. It's the latest mode of transportation. I got a wind generator I can charge one with.
Thank you. favorite.
Now, I take it that y'all are following this music. You know where it all comes from, everybody? You sure you know where this rock and roll comes from? I saw a documentary one time, just absolutely made me sick.
What about you?
Said that rock and roll started in England with the Beatles. They imitated American rock and roll, because there ain't nothing but American rock and roll. I'm going to prove something to you. There ain't nothing but American rock and roll. And this is it. You ever heard rock and roll sung in Chinese? How about Japanese or German? How about this? Just let's get a little closer. With an English accent. No, because they sing American slang, because rock and roll is American. That's right. Now we're going to do a little rock and roll American style for you. back when? When was that? A couple years? Two years ago? It don't matter, this thing rocks, and gonna keep on rocking for eternity. Sometimers?
I'm in love with the girl that I'm talking about. I'm in love with the girl that I can't live without. I'm in love, but I sure picked a bad time to be in love.
I'm in love. Can I get a witness?
know, Alice Cooper, all that Motown stuff, Grand Funk, Bob Seger, and Ted Nugent. And, you know, but it just goes on. I want you to know why. Because it was a multicultural airplane praying to the TV set where Billy Graham was, and I gave my life to Jesus Christ back then. And just to show you something, he never leaves or forsakes you. He kept pestering me the whole time. I was 35 years old when I finally woke up. But thank God I woke up. And the good news is, it ain't nothing that I'm going to do that earns me what I have in him, because he done it all. Man, that's good news. Because if it was up to what I'm doing, baby, we're all burning. But it's up to him. And that's all it took for me, was to believe that God gave us a high priest who didn't have no sin. And when he gave his life, it was for everything to cover me. And when I leave this planet, baby, I'm going home to meet my maker. It is amazing what a prayer can do. Save all your gray skies for another day. I've had my share of all those trials and tears. Now I found someone new who'll make them all disappear. Suddenly they've all how a broken heart grows strong.
Oh, Yeah. Thank you.